The President, please be seated.
Le Président, veuillez vous asseoir.
Ông nôn chấm đẹp bậc cao bên to bậc sạ mạn ca.
The court is now in session.
L'audience d'aujourd'hui est commencée.
Yesterday before the adjournment, we did not finish the schedule that we intended
for. Nous n'avions pas eu le temps hier de terminer.
And today we will continue from where we left off.
Aujourd'hui, nous reprendrons là où nous l'avions laissé.
Time for the prosecution to respond to the objections raised by the three defense teams.
L'accusation aux objections soulevées par les trois équipes de défense.
I now hand over to the co-prosecutors.
You have 1 hour to respond. Qui dispose d'une heure pour répondre
to those objections.
À ces objections.
You may proceed.
Vous avez la parole.
Good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, Council. Good morning,
bonjour,
General
Monsieur
Public.
Le Président, Madame, Messieurs les Juges.
Your Honours, as we mentioned yesterday,
membres du public.
Today I will be addressing generally
comme nous l'avons dit hier,
the prosecution's general objections to the defence objections to the admissibility of the document. And then my learned colleague, Mr. Darrez Mae-Chan, will look at a few of the document types and provide some examples of how that indicia of reliability can be found within the documents.
Des indices de fiabilité que l'on retrouve dans les documents.
Briefly, Your Honour, I think yesterday the defence and the prosecution to a certain extent, we're in general agreement with the legal test for admissibility.
Test juridique
that
de recevabilité
document should be prima facie relevant, on its face relevant,
pertinence
and prima facie
à première vue
reliable,
et
on
la
its face
à
reliable.
Vue. Et
but I think
la
the differences arose in how that
position
test
nos
would be applied,
sont quant à
and
de ce
the difference
test
may have arisen with the manner in which that test be
la
applied.
A parlé de la façon dont on appliquerait ce critère.
But firstly, if I can make, I'll make 4 points in terms of our general response to four general objections that have been raised to the documents. But
points
prior to making those 4 points,
toutefois avant,
I would like to mention a couple of preliminary matters as to how each of the accused or their counsel are approaching the issue of admissibility.
And la façon dont
our view would be is that
that
approach that's being put forward by each of the defense teams is not completely in accordance
et la
with
façon
the practice
ont
and the law
ce critère
as
n'est pas agreed. Tout à fait en
firstly,
et le droit.
In relation to Q Sampan,
tout d'abord, l'équipe
Q Sampan's counsel
de Q Sampan
raised the obligation with Your Honours that the prosecution have the responsibility to prove the prosecution case beyond reasonable doubt. And that's absolutely clear. The prosecution doesn't shy away from that. These are incredibly serious proceedings and the burden of proof is very high for the prosecution. However, what the counsel for the Q Sampan team did was try and equate the burden of proof at the end of the case with
un
the burden of proof
de preuve
to have documents admitted
du procès,
and
quand,
it's submitted
la de preuve
on the law that we
document
presented yesterday and the law that was placed in our pleadings
et
that clearly that's not the case.
Nous avons indiqué
at the admissibility
dans les points de droit
stage
que nous
the,
avons
all
parlé
that need be shown
de la recevabilité,
is prima facie relevant
il faut
and prima facie reliable. There's a reason for that, of course, that if each piece of evidence had to be proved beyond all reasonable doubt, we would have trials within trials,
nous
and the process will never end.
De
the safeguard
la
for the accused
ne terminerait jamais
is that the material facts in the indictment must be proved beyond reasonable doubt.
Il faut, and Your Honours, we submit les faits allégués
can only arrive at that if Your Honours looks at the full compass, the full scope of the evidence to determine if all of those pieces add up on any particular
si
primary allegation to find that fact proved beyond reasonable doubt.
Si tous les éléments de preuve permettent de prouver ce fait allégué hors de tout doute raisonnable,
the admissibility of evidence,
si les
the problem that will be faced is that Your Honours will never get to look at any evidence
because cela signifie que vous ne pourrez jamais être saisi des éléments de preuve, car il s'agirait d'un examen beaucoup trop lourd pour chaque
so des éléments de preuve there, but the test is much lower for
donc,
those obvious reasons.
Le critère est
if we move to Nguyen Chia,
plus faible pour
again, there was general agreement on the test.
Avec l'équipe de
However,
Nguyen Chia, nous semblons être
your,
d'accord
your Honours were asked to steer away from international
mais
practice in terms of international tribunals dealing with cases of this type,
notamment
with their
avec
approach
les tribunaux internationaux
on admissibility.
Et leur approche
counsel for Nguyen Chia stated that the approach of the international tribunals is perhaps a more liberal approach than in national courts, whether it be Cambodia or any other court. And the reason for that, of course, is that these cases are so big that if Your Honours applied a strict approach to the admissibility of evidence, you would not see the full breadth of the evidence that Your Honours have to take in
tous les éléments de preuve dont elle
determine whether or not mass crimes against humanity across
si
Cambodia in fact occurred.
Crimes contre l'humanité ont été commis au Cambodge. On ne peut citer à comparaître tous les témoins. On ne peut avoir d'originaux pour chacun des éléments de preuve. On ne peut avoir la filière de conservation pour chaque document.
Other ways in which you can,
il doit donc y avoir une autre façon
the evidence so that your judgment is based on a rich set of facts rather than isolated pieces that perhaps would not connect and would take away from the integrity of the judgment. So although the Nguyen Chia agreed generally with the legal test for admissibility, they've asked
le
Your Honours to steer away from the international practice,
de vous éloigner des
and we suggest you should not do that because it's the international tribunals
that, have, tribunaux that are working with cases of these sizes,
and
aussi
such
que celui-ci,
liberal approach is
que
important
plus ouvertes,
if Your Honours wants to see all the evidence.
Fondamental, si
that said,
vous voulez
we agree with the Nguyen Chia team that it's important that this court applies fundamental principles which apply to the Cambodian courts because that's required under the law, but also this court needs to set an example. And by applying
a
fair process or fair trial rights, protecting the interests of the
accused,
making sure civil parties' interests are protected, and also making sure that Your Honours get to see all of the evidence,
you can
adopt those principles that are the same as at the national courts, and so it can be very instructive for the national courts as to how
servira
trials
de modèle
should progress.
Pour les tribunaux cambodgiens
but when it becomes to the technicalities of
pour ce qui est,
admissibility
contre,
of evidence and some of those international standards that are adopted, we submit Your Honours should adopt them because the national courts are not dealing
adopter, car les
with cases of this size.
Ne traitent pas d'affaires aussi complexes que celle-ci.
Finally, in relation to the Yang Sari defence, again,
puis,
there's general agreement on
la
test of
admissibility.
However,
avec
I think the test that was specifically put forward was a little academic and not quite
était un peu abstrait.
Practical or workable et in a court, this court or any court.
Vraiment,
and as Your Honours remember, the Yang Sari team put forward or counsel put forward that the admissibility test should be in three stages.
Le critère devrait se faire en trois étapes.
One, that Your Honours should first look at authenticity of the document, and then if it's authentic, you should move to the next stage. Is it reliable? And then and only then, you should look at whether or not the evidence is relevant. Apart from the fact that we agree with the Yangtze Council that those elements are a part, of the test, but as we have said yesterday, and the international jurisprudence shows that authenticity is in fact an element of reliability, so it's incorporated with that analysis. And the idea that you only look at authenticity and reliability first and then relevant, what that can lead to is a prolonged process where if the evidence is clearly irrelevant at the outset, much time has been wasted to get to that point. So Your Honours have adopted a different approach. Your Honours have adopted, you've asked the prosecution and the other parties to put in their documents,
April last year,
and you've asked the parties to establish the relevance, which has been done. And so we would say that the approach is that the relevance and reliability is largely done at the same time, and that's how this process can be workable. Moving now, Your Honours, to the four general objections, or the four general responses we have to the defence objections to the documents. I think either singularly or combined, the defence raise four points as to why these documents, the majority of the documents that are supporting the closing order, should not be admitted. Firstly, it's been put forward by the defence that the accused has an absolute right to summon any author of any document at all, pursuant to Rule 84.1. And as Your Honours are aware, Rule 84.1 gives the defence the right to summon any witness that they haven't had an opportunity to question during the investigation phase. We would submit, Your Honours, the interpretation of that rule is such that that relates to witnesses that have provided statements or written records to the investigative judges. It doesn't apply to other types of documents like media statements or books or academic articles or academic reports. Because at the international courts, when they apply the evidentiary rules to cases of this size, rather than asking for the authors to come, they allow hearsay evidence. They allow out-of-court statements made by others to be taken into account by Your Honours because of the sizes of the case. They allow media reports produced at the time of the event, contemporaneous with the event, to be used as corroborative evidence to the other evidence in the case. They allow books, they allow academic articles, and they allow analytical reports. And the reason why they allow them is because those reports and books provide Your Honours with guidance and very informed advice as to the context, the historical background, the general policies of the background to the indictment. The effort that is required to put all that evidence into a cohesive form is massive. It's people's life's work. And as a result of that, the courts have allowed these types of documents to come in as an exception to the right to question every witness, because they are valuable. They allow Your Honours to see how the context in which the evidence that you are particularly hearing, whether it be oral testimony or other documentary evidence, can be put into place.
Et permettent donc de remettre ces témoignages et
normally,
documentaires en
documents of that type are used as corroboration rather than the primary evidence, rather than the oral testimony or other very significant contemporaneous documents.
Ou des documents d'époque.
important.
We've provided those cases and the pleadings that support that, and we would
nous
ask Your Honours to follow that international practice. Otherwise, what will happen is
sinon,
you will rob yourself of the opportunity to see how the matrix of evidence fits together.
But d'avoir une vue d'ensemble.
The way the international courts have looked at that type of evidence, that it's a question of weight rather
dans
than admissibility.
Ce n'est pas une
so, for example,
de recevabilité, mais bien une
if
question de
an accused
à accorder
makes
à par exemple,
50 statements
si un
during
fait une cinquantaine de déclarations,
say, the Democratic Kampuchea period,
pendant
and
la
all those
du
statements
démocratique,
are of a similar type,
de ces déclarations
of a similar policy, if they all come from different media sources or different outlets, but they're all saying the same thing, at the end, Your Honours can place great weight on that, subject to
chose,
any substantive channel challenge by the defence.
D'y accorder le point nécessaire,
so we would ask Your Honours to follow the international jurisprudence on these other
nous
types
vous
of documents,
de la
allow them in
internationale pour
so that Your Honours can have that context, and allow them in so that Your Honours can see all of the evidence that's available, rather than just the memory of a witness 40 years later that comes into the court.
Tous les éléments de preuve possibles plutôt que de dépendre simplement de la mémoire.
Secondly, Your Honours,
qui vient 40 ans après les faits.
The defence generally
deuxième
have
point,
objected to documents going in unless the original transcripts or tape recordings of a witness or an accused statement contained in any document
des déclarations de témoins
is placed before the court or whether they have access to it.
Les enregistrements ou la
we would submit that there isn't an express right for that to demand media reports that were produced, say, for example, back in 75 to 79, to demand that original transcripts of those reports or original notes of those reports, those many, many reports, to be brought forward, we would say it's far too onerous and far too costly for the court. Your Honours can look at the reliability of that evidence by looking at how it fits with the context of other evidence. Is it consistent? Is it internally consistent? And does it externally, is it externally corroborated by events? Your Honours, we went through all the different criteria that we propose that can be used to determine that minimum level of reliability, but we would say demanding notes
de fiabilité, mais d'exiger les notes
tape recordings,
d'un journaliste,
transcripts
des enregistrements,
of interviews
les transcriptions
done years earlier is a far too costly exercise, but without much benefit
lourd,
in terms of being able to determine its reliability.
Ne permettra pas nécessairement
but as Your Honours know, under the rule,
comme
under Rule 25, in relation to the written records, the defence have a right to look at the tape recordings of all the witnesses, the written statements of the witnesses in the case file. And if there's an anomaly, they can bring that up to Your Honours. Ideally, as the prosecution have said, it would be useful if all of those tape recordings were transcribed, and if all of those tape recordings were available, but it's a lengthy exercise, and we are saying that Your Honours should not not allow the admission of those written records just because that transcript of that statement hasn't been provided. Because remember, the witness has at the bottom of that statement signed and said, this is a true and accurate account of what I have told the investigators. So any small nuance between a question and answer method and the summary of the evidence is counterbalanced by the fact that the witness has had an opportunity to read the statement and say, sign it as a true accounting of events. Your Honours, if I go back one step, we do agree with the defence that there is a right for the defence to request the presence of witnesses that have given written records to the OCIJ as to the acts and conduct of the accused. And the reason why we agree with that, because we believe that's the state of the law at the international tribunals. As Your Honour is aware, at these tribunals,
evidence
is allowed to be presented to the trial chamber in statement form without calling the witness
if,
as long as they don't relate to the acts and conduct of the accused, and if so, before Your Honour places any reliance on that evidence, that witness should be available to be called.
Si
so
we,
that's the position the prosecution have in relation to written records. So we would submit that Your Honour accepts the written records in the historical background section of the indictment,
where
they purport to show the historical background,
pour ce qui est du contexte
policies, structure, etc.
Pour les politiques,
but don't accept it on the basis that where it shows provides evidence of the acts and conduct of the accused, that Your Honours put that evidence aside and not take that into account. But for every other reason we submit, those statements should be accepted. Thirdly, Your Honours, there seems to be a general objection that unless a significant chain of custody for all of these documents can be proved, that the documents should in fact not be admitted. As explained yesterday, Your Honours, the international jurisprudence on admissibility in terms of reliability, it doesn't require any one criteria of reliability to be a prerequisite for the admission of any particular document. It doesn't require that it be shown to the court that the chain of custody from the discovery of the document to the admission into the courtroom be proved every step of the way over the last 35 years. It doesn't require that. It doesn't require that because largely it can often be too difficult and too time-consuming, and in fact, the proceedings will take far too long.
Et cela reviendra à allonger la procédure.
What the ultimate goal is in terms of admissibility is determine whether it's got that minimum level of reliability.
D'avoir un
so
seuil minimal de fidélité.
The argument is, why do you take the long road
donc, pourquoi
when there's a shorter road to take in terms of looking at the internal characteristics and the external characteristics of the
court,
document?
C'est-à-dire les caractéristiques
if we take the long road to every piece of evidence and finding the reliability of every piece of evidence to that nth degree, this trial, of course, won't end. And it's not necessary,
détail,
it's not required under the law.
Et ce n'est pas nécessaire, ce n'est pas
in terms of the prosecution, there was some criticism that the prosecution somehow wasn't concerned with chain of custody or perhaps there was not much evidence on file about the chain of custody of these documents. I think it's quite clear that there are many witnesses on the case file, you know, for example, telegram witnesses, witnesses that can testify to telegrams showing the authenticity of those documents. There's a witness from the printing house that produced the revolutionary flag and the red flag. That witness is on the case file. We've asked
voilà
that witness to come to court.
Nous avons demandé
we have statements from
Yuk Chang,
the director of the documentation center of Cambodia, as to the authenticity or at least the custody of those documents.
I mean,
the director's opinion on any particular
conservation,
test for authenticity is one thing, but really it's up to Your Honours to decide
how
you would determine the reliability of a document.
De la façon
Your Honours, the prosecution has document. Put forward in the witness list, and Your Honours have decided to call
nous
someone from the Documentation Centre of Cambodia.
Du centre
and
de documentation
that witness that Your Honour has decided to call
ce témoin
is
que
quite
la Chambre
able
a choisi de faire
to testify to the custody of
de
documents.
Parler
that witness
de la
has
documents.
Been at DC Camp for 15
ce
years.
Témoin travaille
that
au DC Camp
witness has been at the organisation for about the same length of time as Yuk Chang.
Et
so we would submit as much as
que Yuk Chang.
Chain of custody. Your Honours require some further proof of some custody of documents,
si
the witness you have selected, which we have put forward, is quite able and quite appropriate
to be able to provide that extra information.
The prosecution hasn't shied away from the fact that Yuk Chang does have valuable information, but so, so does the other witness that Your Honour has selected. And we would suggest that before any decision about calling anyone else in relation to chain of custody
of documents from
DC CAM, that Your Honour hear the testimony as you've decided to. Again, chain of custody not being an essential requirement to prove liability, but ultimately Your Honours have to be satisfied,
and
so we welcome that evidence.
Utile, et c'est pourquoi nous accueillons favorablement
just one general comment about the defence's views that regardless of whether or not chain of custody can be provided to the court
de la défense,
in relation to a number of the documents, any document that was housed by DC CAM or stored by DC CAM or under their custody should not be admitted into this courtroom is just illogical. It doesn't make any sense.
Because
what the defence is saying is that because the Documentation Centre of Cambodia, one of its goals or mandates is to look at and search for the truth during the democratic Kampuchea period, because they have said that genocide, that's a lay person's term, often it's used in that way, even though it's a specific legal meaning. But because crimes against humanity have occurred in Cambodia, or there's a recognition of that, somehow or another, they are biased. To be fair, Your Honours, that is a ludicrous point to make. Of course, they are not acting for any particular defence or
Evidemment,
any particular victim, but they're searching for the truth.
D'une victime and ou d'une équipe de défense particulière, mais bien,
whatever the mandate of the organisation, that doesn't relate any bias or any sort of goal of that organisation. That can't be imported to the documents that they house. The question of admissibility relates to the documents,
dans leurs archives,
but not to the organisation itself.
By
saying that any organisation, for example, a police force that investigates crimes is necessarily biased, and because of that fact, any of the evidence they collect should not be placed before the court,
just doesn't make sense.
I mean, everyone has an ethical obligation, of course, to ensure that whatever investigations are carried out appropriately. That would be like the prosecution saying that any document put forward by the defence team, by the Nguyen Chia Yang Sari defence team, is biased because they have interests in protecting, they have a responsibility to protect their clients' interests. Of course, that's not the case, and of course, we wouldn't object on that basis. The bias or the lack of reliability has to relate to the document,
but not to the organisation.
Finally, Your Honours,
enfin, Madame, Messieurs les juges,
there, in relation to a general objection by Q Sampan, it appears that counsel for Q Sampan are complaining somehow or another that they're not getting an opportunity to examine the documents. And demanding that at some stage or another we need to have the opportunity to examine the documents.
Autre, il faudra avoir l'occasion d'examiner les documents.
Your Honours are doing this now.
C'est ce
we're
fait
doing
à présent
this
la
right
Chambre.
Now, and we've been doing it for the last
et
4 years.
Defence
counsel for Q Sampan and others have
accessed
this case file for 4 years.
Consulter le dossier depuis 4 ans.
Their responsibility, our responsibility, has been to examine those documents over that period.
C'est d'examiner ces
then,
documents tout au long de cette
Your
période.
Honours, we have provided in response to your order,
et en
a list
aux
of the documents
de la Chambre, nous
that
avons une liste
we
de documents
are going to rely on or put forward to the
nous
Chamber.
Nous appuyer,
and as Your Honours are aware, we provided a list of about
4,500
documents,
il y a environ 6,500
about 6,500, but about 4,500 relating to the first phase.
Raccord,
and we've described every document, we've dated it, we've referenced
phase,
it. We've said how it's relevant.
We provided that on the 19th of April in 2011.
The defense is aware of the rules that at some point in the trial, they actually have to have an opinion on the documents. The rules say that.
I
give your honors the right to ask the parties to object to documents prior to the trial or shortly after the trial begins.
Avant le début du procès,
to
un peu après le début du procès.
Then, your honors,
ensuite,
your honors have invited the parties to object to the documents in writing. Everyone has taken that opportunity.
Par écrit.
And then your honors
chacun
have provided for these hearings
quoi, les juges
where people can put their comments
prévu
forward.
La présente audience
your honors have seen the prosecution's Rule 92 statement, basically
a 40 or 50 page
statement outlining indicia of reliability for
exposant
all
les indices de fiabilité de toutes
les
catégories de documents.
Forever and ever,
nous pourrions continuer indéfiniment à présenter des indices
point,
de fiabilité,
your honors,
mais
we would
à un moment ou à un autre,
the prosecution
selon nous,
has undertaken its burden,
il faut considérer que l'accusation a fait ce qui lui incombait.
To your honors,
elle a
the prima facie,
établi
on its face,
des
the documents are reliable.
La fiabilité
we have done
à première
that
vue des documents.
Your honors have provided us an opportunity this week
déjà fait par écrit, nous pouvons à présent le faire oralement sur les annexes 1 à 5.
We have another 15 annexes,
il y a
which we would like to put before
15 autres
the court,
annexes que nous voulons
and we welcome
déposer.
The opportunity and we recognize, Your Honor's scheduling of other documentary hearings. But, Your Honors, we would submit, if it's a complaint from the QSAMPAN team
pour
that they're not getting
an
opportunity to examine the documents, we would submit
si la défense
it's wholly unfounded.
Prétend qu'elle n'a pas eu l'occasion d'examiner les documents,
the opportunity
nous affirmons
is now,
que c'est tout à fait
and the opportunity is this week.
Gratuit.
And the opportunity is
c'est
through those
cette
pleadings.
Semaine, c'est par
if the parties don't take that opportunity, that's really a question for them. But you've
ont
allowed for the opportunity for examination of the documents.
Existe,
we
si
would
elle
submit
pas pour examiner
that
documents,
does not mean
cela
that the parties sit day in and day out reading document
cela ne veut pas dire
document
que les parties doivent
I mean, we will be here for years.
Lire
the opportunity has been provided.
Interminable
and,
documents jour et nuit,
we would ask
car
your honors
le procès
to accept that
des
fact, and then
nous en sommes bien conscients.
Make your findings on those documents.
Au juge
and then,
de tirer
to
leur
conclude,
conclusion
at the end, your
documents.
Honors, we would say that it's really a question of weight for these documents.
La question qui se pose est une question de
points.
Une fois que
once
les documents sont réputés recevables à première vue, une fois que l'on a établi que le document était ce qu'il prétendait être, ces documents
so
doivent être admis de façon à pouvoir examiner les preuves déjà déposées.
We submit that your honors have a duty, of
selon
course, to ascertain the truth
il
of the indictment
au juge,
and also
sûr,
a duty to protect and the accused's rights.
La vérité et de préserver
we
les
ask
accusés.
That the duty to ascertain the truth requires
le
you to look at the evidence
broadly
la vérité
passe
and
par un
requires
large
you to look at
preuves,
the admissibility
faire,
rules of the international jurisprudence
des règles de
so that
qui découlent de la
you can get a full impression of the evidence and then at the end of the case determine
preuves,
the weight that should be placed on each piece of evidence.
Que les juges déterminent le poids à accorder à chaque
Your Honours, I would now turn to my colleague, Mr.
Darozmay
Chan, and he will
Monsieur
just provide, in relation to a few groups of documents, some of the indicators that we've recognized already in our written pleadings as to the authenticity of those documents. And as Your Honour is aware, many
documents.
Of the documents
comme
in the background
savez,
section
bon
of the closing order are also included in annexes 1 to 5.
Sont
and so
dans
some,
les 1 à 5.
Some of those responses in relation to perhaps the interview of Kiem Nguyen
pour ce qui est, par exemple,
will
de
be put forward
de
by a colleague in the next hearing.
But if nous I allons turn to examiner cela lors des prochaines audiences. Je donne la parole à mon confrère.
Mr. Darozmay. Good morning, Mr. President, and good morning, Your Honours. And good morning, everybody,
bonjour,
everyone in
Madame,
the
Messieurs
court room. My name is Yann Darozmay. I'm the deputy co-prosecutor.
Je suis co-procureur adjoint.
I would now like to respond
à
to
présent,
what the defense teams have
ma
argued.
Réponse
I would like to bring up
aux objections
some of the
par les équipes de défense.
Evidence. The first response is concerning with the video. The second one on the history of the Democratic Cambodia.
Ensuite, je passerai
the third one on
à l'histoire
the
du Cambodia démocratique, puis
minutes of the Democratic Cambodia
de
in
du Cambodia démocratique,
fourth on the Democratic Cambodia communications,
les communications du
attachment
Cambodia démocratique, annexe 4,
that includes the FUNC,
y compris le FUNC,
and the KRUNC.
Et le GRUNC.
And then I will look at the the Democratic Cambodia media and public statements in attachment 5
Cambodia démocratique, annexe 5.
And as for the document relating to video, I will address Yeng Sari's objections to the two videos. These documents
E3/81
or D108/32.2 and E3/124A or D299.1.46A. The first video entitled Pol Pot's Shadow is objected on the basis that it is an annex to an OCP request seeking for the material to be admitted in case
001.
The defense argued that as the request to which the video relates is not relevant to the case, the attached video is therefore inadmissible.
À la présente affaire et que par conséquent, la vidéo
this objection lacks any substance.
Recevable. Une telle objection est dénuée de tout
the fact that this video is attached to an OCP request in case 001 is an irrelevant consideration for admissibility.
Est dénuée de toute pertinence du point de vue de la recevabilité.
The relevance of this evidence attaches to the video, particularly the interview with Nguyen Chia on his position and role in the Democratic Cambodia period.
Contient une interview de Nguyen Chia portant sur son rôle
the second video,
du Cambodia démocratique.
The BBC's
la
Phil Rees Cambodia report, including Nguyen Chia interview, is objected on the basis that the video only contains portions of the full interview with Nguyen Chia and that the original responses are unable to be heard. They state makes it difficult to ascertain how contextually accurate the interview is.
Difficile
although it is not ideal that Nguyen Chia's voice cannot be heard over the translation, there is nothing to suggest that the BBC,
certes,
a reputable news organization, selectively or misleadingly edited or mistranslated the interview.
Rien ne permet de prétendre que la BBC,
consequently,
qui est un organisme
it is on its face admissible.
Et
the objection should be rejected, particularly on the basis that Nguyen Chia has not claimed that the interview has been inaccurately translated.
Cette pièce doit être considérée à première vue comme étant recevable. Il
convient
de rejeter l'objection
soulevée. Both videos are clearly relevant, as they are interviews with Nguyen Chia providing relevant information on his role during the Democratic Cambodia period.
Les deux vidéos sont
Your Honours,
car il s'agit
for the CPK publication in Annex 2, I would like to respond as follows. I will address Yeng Sari's objection to the nine Communist Party of Cambodia publications.
Je vais parler
these are documents E3/5 or D243/21.1,
E3/99,
or
IS6.2,
E3/12, or IS6.3, E3/50
E3/50
or D366/7.1.61 E3/4 bracket D123/21 close bracket
3.1
or IS 11.9 and D123/3.1 E3/10 or D243/21.7 E3/25 or D243/21.9 E3/11 or D243/2.1.12 and E3/23 or D135/1. Seven of these documents are CPK publications, which include five editions of the revolutionary flag, plus one directive and one DK government document. Inseri has generally objected on the basis that the reliability and authenticity of the documents have not been substantiated and they had no opportunity to confront the author of the documents. However, the defense have failed to show how the relevancy of the documents as stated in the closing order and the co-prosecutor's document list is in error.
Les documents
the prosecution relies on the statement of relevance in both documents. These documents are clearly relevant to the history, structure, and policies of the Communist Party of Cambodia and the Revolutionary Army of Cambodia. As to their reliability, these documents focus on CPK economic, strategic, and military policies and activities. They contain distinctive expressions that are commonly associated with the CPK and in keeping with the CPK ideology. For example, the articles use expressions such as Revolutionary Army, American Imperialist, and SMASH. The purpose of the publication is clearly to indoctrinate party members in known policies and the objectives of the CPK. The revolutionary flag was officially published and distributed by the Ministry of Propaganda out of various offices. Various witnesses, including Nguyen Chir, have confirmed that the revolutionary flag was a CPK publication and that members of the Standing Committee, including Nguyen Chir and Pol Pot, wrote articles for it. Your Honours,
Madame, Messieurs les juges,
the editions of the revolutionary flag contain consistent markings and have similar layout. The front cover page displays two or more flags, the communist hammer and sickle. A symbol is displayed at the beginning of each chapter and on the back cover page. Similarly, one of the CPK publications also contains the same hammer and sickle symbol throughout. A number of editions of revolutionary flag included on the document list were admitted into evidence in case 001. All editions of the revolutionary flag are practically identical. As such, the characteristics of reliability of the documents identified and or authenticated by witnesses and or admitted into evidence in case 001 are shared by all other editions of these publications on the document list. The CPK directive E3/12 entitled Decision of the Central Committee regarding a number of matters dated the 30th of March 1976 La directive is relevant to showing the establishment of the organizational structure of the CPK, including the legal authority of the accused Nguyen Chia as chairman of the Democratic Cambodia People's Assembly, Khieu Somphorn as the chairman of the Democratic Cambodia State Presidium, and Ieng Sary as the Deputy Prime Minister for Foreign Affairs. The directive also shows the accused's knowledge of and participation in CPK policy making, including unlawful killing. Your Honours, the title of the directive confirms the document is from the Central Committee,
ainsi que leur participation à la mise en œuvre de ces politiques.
Other CPK publications, the directive uses distinctive terminology associated with the CPK, such as mass and imperialist America, and the content of this document consistent with known CPK policies. The document has been identified as authentic by DCCAM Director Chang Gyuk and was admitted as evidence in the Dutch trial. Your Honours, I would like to respond to the meeting minutes in Annex 3. And this meeting minutes, we have already submitted our arguments.
Déjà présenté nos arguments à ce sujet.
And I will address Ieng Sary's objection to the Revolutionary Army of Cambodia meeting minutes, document E3/13 or IS-13.34. This document was produced by the Revolutionary Army of Cambodia on the 9th of October 1976. And entitled Meeting of Secretaries and Deputies of Divisions and Independent Regiments. Ieng Sary objects to the admission of this document unless its authenticity, reliability, and relevance can be sufficiently demonstrated and its author can be examined. If admitted, the defense argues that only limited evidentiary weight, if any, should be given to it unless the content of the document can be verified and supported through independent indicia of reliability. This is in fact the prosecutor's position, that the author of a document should not necessarily be called if its authenticity can be established in another way. This will assist in expediting the proceedings.
À savoir que l'auteur d'un document ne doit pas nécessairement être
cité. As to relevance, in light of Ieng Sary's defense failure to explain why the relevance identified in the closing order allegation and that identified by the prosecution in its first phase document list is not valid, this aspect of the objection should be dismissed. It is not a good use of the court time to repeat the relevance of the documents that have been provided in great detail in our document list provided to the parties in April and then again in July last year. As to its reliability, there are many characteristics which tend to prove that the document is authentic, such as 1. The source, it has a known author, the rack, 2. The form, the page layout and typeface are identical or very similar to other military meeting minutes, including those identified by Kang Kek-yu, alias Dutch. And 3, the content is consistent with the CPK activities of arresting, interrogating, or removing traitors and the uses of terms common to the CPK, such as smashing.
Further, custody of a copy of the document
was handed over to the OCP from the DC camp during the OCP's preliminary investigations. It is admitted these indicia of authenticity are sufficient, particularly in the absence of indicators to the contrary, to satisfy the prima facie reliability test for admission. Consequently, the author need not be called for questioning. Now I would like to respond to the issue concerning Democratic Cambodia government statements and Fung or Krung publication in Annex 5.
Funk et du Grunk et aux déclarations du gouvernement du Cambodia démocratique. Il s'agit de l'annexe 5.
In Sari objects that the probative value of the document is outweighed by their prejudicial effect, and that the document is unreliable and unsuitable to prove facts it purports to prove.
Sur leur valeur probante, et prétend aussi que ces documents ne sont pas fiables,
and that the accused has not had the opportunity to confront the author of the document. Again, Insuri does not provide a factual basis for his objection. For these reasons, it is requested this particular objection be dismissed. As to relevance, this document assists in providing factual legal authority of the accused in the pre-DK period. For example, they named Khieu Somphone as Prime Minister at interim and detailed various visits by all of the accused to foreign countries as part of the official delegation.
Par exemple,
these documents assist in proofing the accused membership in a joint criminal, enterprise. As to reliability, indicators of authenticity include 1. The source of document. They are marked as being official publications of the Fung or the Royal Government of National Union of Cambodia Department of Press and Information. 2. The date, which is contemporaneous with the events they record, and 3. Official markings, such as a coat of arms, 4. The purpose of the document, namely to indoctrinate people in the policy, and objectives of the Fung or Krung, and to criticize Vietnam, is clearly identifiable and is consistent with the known policies and objectives of the authors. And 5, all of the documents were provided by DCCAM, an organization whose purpose is to collect and analyze evidence from the DK regime. For example, the authenticity of E3/114, an issue of the National Union of Cambodia Front, a publication entitled Nouvelle du Cambodge, can be seen by its title page. This page identifies the document as being a publication of Agent Cambodia Dong Famation, and contains a specific address. It includes an issue number as well. It can be seen that the format of this document, with the title and a table of contents on the front page, it is consistent with the other issues of the Nouvelle du Cambodge,
notamment pour ce qui est du titre et.
In light of Ying Sari's failure to state why the document was not relevant, as indicated by the reference to the factual allegations in the closing order, and as indicated specifically in the prosecution's list phase document, document list, we ask that these specific objections be dismissed.
Pour la nous Your Honours,
I would like to now present
Madame, Messieurs les juges,
on the DK media reports.
J'en viens à présent au rapport des médias
object to the admission of these documents on the basis that the probative value on the document is outweighed by their prejudicial effect. They state they are unreliable and the author of the documents are unknown. Again, the Yangtze defense failed to substantiate by the relevance identified in the closing order and the co-prosecutors. First phase document list is not valid. With that failure, the prosecution relies on relevance of these documents as indicted in the closing order and first phase document listed to avoid repetition. As to reliability, as discussed already, it is not necessary for the author of any document to be called if the authenticity of a document can be satisfied in other ways. In general, these DK media reports comprises of a group of contemporaneous reports dealing with issues relevant to this trial. These documents assist in proofing the administrative structure of the CPK and relate to the first phase of the population movement.
Ces documents aident à prouver quelle était la structure administrative du PCK et ils sont donc en rapport avec la première phase,
The documents originate from an official source, the media apparatus of the CPK, and they are consistent in style with each other and employ a distinctive syntax appropriate to the nature of the document. For example, frequent use of the terms U.S. imperialist and the traitorous Ronald Click. And the information contained in the document is corroborated by various other documents on the case file and is clearly consistent with the known policies and practices of the CPK during this period. Specifically, document E3/119, also known as B262.9, discusses the fact of phase one of the forced population movement, the reasons behind the policy, and also the appointment of individuals to positions within the party. This document clearly goes towards issues that are relevant to the current phase of the proceedings and provide important contextual information.
Désignation de certaines personnes au sein du parti
in response to the defense's assertion that evidence is inadmissible where the author is unknown, it should be noted that although proof as to the origin of the documents in general custody is relevant in considering whether a document has sufficient indicia of reliability,
it
is not a prerequisite for admission.
Si la preuve de l'origine d'un document et de la chaîne de conservation est pertinente pour déterminer si un document présente assez d'indices de fiabilité, ce n'est pas une condition à remplir pour que le document en question soit déclaré recevable.
The International Criminal Tribunal of the former Yugoslavia, in the
dans l'affaire
of prosecutor versus Oric, in their judgment dated 30 June 2006
at paragraphs 27 to 28, de ce jugement.
Quote, the trial chamber does not consider that proof of chain of custody is a sine qua non or an essential requirement for admissibility.
D'établir la filière de conservation d'un document pour
gaps in
en
the chain of custody
la recevabilité.
Les provided that the evidence as a whole demonstrates beyond reasonable doubt that the piece of evidence concerned is what it purports to be.
que dans l'ensemble, les éléments de preuve prouvent, au-delà de tout doute raisonnable, que l'élément de preuve en question est ce qu'il prétend être.
Fin citation. Having the minimum levels of relevance and
reliability. Comme indiqué précédemment, devant les CETC, la pratique a consisté à admettre les rapports des médias qui présentent un seuil minimal de la finance et de fiabilité. Dans le dossier numéro 1, les juges ont admis 85 rapports médiatiques du Kampuchea démocratique et 135 rapports des médias internationaux evidence. En tant que preuve.
This practice is in line with the international tribunals where press reports are often admitted
où des articles de presse ont souvent
été admis et où ils sont généralement
traités comme preuve documentaire plutôt que comme déclaration de témoin. En particulier,
particularly s'il if they are contemporaneous
de
reports.
Rapports d'époque.
The documents
de
in this group
évidence,
clearly
les documents
meet the
de cette
minimum
catégorie
level of reliability threshold
de
required,
qui est prescrit,
and in the absence of any specific factual doubt as to the authenticity of the document,
du document,
there is no basis upon which these types of documents should be
raison d'écarter cette catégorie de documents.
So they should be considered as evidence and so be admitted.
Et devront être considérés comme élément de preuve, être jugés recevables. Mesdames, Messieurs les juges, donc ce que je viens de faire, c'est... Enfin, je viens d'offrir une réponse aux objections soulevées par la défense.
If my colleague has anything further to
si
add to
mon confrère
my speech, then
a quelque chose
may,
à ajouter,
proceed.
Je lui laisse volontiers la parole et j'apprécie votre attention. Le président,
thank you,
je vous remercie.
The chamber would now hand the floor to
la Chambre
the
souhaite maintenant laisser
co-lawyers.
La parole aux co-avocats principaux pour les parties civiles.
To respond.
Pour leur réponse.
You have 15 minutes.
Vous disposez de 15 minutes.
To do so, you
pour
may now proceed.
Faire votre intervention et vous avez la parole.
Litco lawyer, thank you, Mr. President.
Le
good morning, Your Honours.
Principal. Je vous remercie, Monsieur
good
le Président.
Morning,
bonjour,
everyone,
Madame,
good morning
Messieurs
to
les
the
juges. Bonjour
public
à tous.
Gallery.
Jean,
we
dans
will
la galerie réservée au public.
Use the 15 minute time allocation
nous allons
response
utiliser l'intégralité des 15 minutes qui nous ont été données pour
teams.
Répondre aux objections soulevées par la défense.
In particular on the admissibility of the documents.
Sur le sujet
we
de la recevabilité des documents.
This court consists of a body of the investigative judges.
Le tribunal est
all the, all the documents
constitué d'un bureau des juges d'instruction
and submitted by the co-prosecutors as well as by the co-investigating judges have been used by the co-investigating judges
présentés par l'accusation
during their investigative phase
ont servi
and that they have been examined
ces
on its reliability.
Ont été, c'est-à-dire la fiabilité de ces documents a déjà été considérée par
and
les co-juges d'instruction.
If the documents have already been used by the co-investigating judges, in particular in their closing order,
le fait que les co-juges d'instruction fassent référence à ces documents dans leur ordonnance de clôture,
admissible before the trial chamber.
Ils doivent être jugés recevables par la chambre de première instance.
Our internal rules also give the express right
le
to the defense teams to raise their objections to the inadmissibility
défense,
of those documents.
Quant à la recevabilité de ces documents.
During this hearing, if they are of the opinion that those documents cannot be admitted. That is
si
the
procès,
burden of the defense team to prove that the documents should not be admitted. And it is not the burden
reçu,
of the prosecution
à la
to prove
de prouver
so.
qu'il n'est pas recevable et ce n'est pas à la à l'accusation de le faire.
Another point that I'd like to raise that is regarding the authenticity of the documents.
Je vais maintenant soulever un autre point quant à l'authenticité des documents.
I support the arguments raised by the prosecution and I'd like to add that
j'appuie l'accusation dans ces arguments et j'ajouterai
between the authenticity of the documents and the original documents. Nunchi and his defense team
entre l'authenticité des documents et son
raised on a couple of occasions that they demand the original copy of the documents.
Nunchi a exigé de consulter l'original.
When the prosecution raised the issue of the revolutionary flag,
par exemple,
an extract from that magazine,
révolutionnaire.
The original copy of a document and the authenticity is not one same thing.
L'original.
Authenticity
et l'authenticité
refers to a document
sont deux concepts différents. L'authenticité
which is proper and
fait
official.
Référence à un document
it could be an original
officiel
copy,
et correct, et cela peut être
or a copy of the original copy with a proper custodianship
dont la conservation a été
therefore,
établie.
The request for the original copy of the document, which as we all know, has been more than 30 years old.
Le, donc, l'original,
is extremely difficult
sait,
or impossible for the prosecution to do so.
Plus de 30 ans.
For that reason, a proper copy of the original document without any
adéquate,
alteration,
sans aucune modification de cet original,
shall be considered admissible.
Doit être
and that has been stipulated in
recevable.
Our internal regarding the minimum standard of admissibility of documents.
Et on le retrouve dans le règlement quant au critère minimal de recevabilité des documents.
As for the request to summon witnesses to appear before the chamber,
la défense a demandé
or the authors of documents
que
or
les auteurs des documents soient cités à comparaître.
Or various other reports,
que ce soit les ouvrages, les publications ou d'autres rapports,
would mean it's going to delay the proceedings.
Une telle pratique
this would
rallongerait la procédure.
The large volume of documents, books or articles written by journalists or researchers. If there is a need to demand its author of every piece of documents to appear before the chamber, can you imagine how long it will take to proceed with the hearing in this case? It is unlikely that it's possible to do so. And as we all know from the internal rules, the proceedings shall be expeditious.
Le règlement intérieur prévoit une procédure
and it is
rapide.
Not possible to call every author of a book or article to appear in this regard.
Et il n'est donc pas possible de faire comparaître tous les auteurs de chaque document.
This is our submission, Your Honor, and I would
voici
like now to
notre réponse.
Get a permission
et
from Mr. President for my colleague.
Laisser la parole à ma consoeur
continue with our statement. Thank you.
Pour la suite de notre réponse. Merci.
Oui, bonjour, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Madame et Monsieur les juges.
Good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honors, and good morning to everyone. A few very brief remarks. The first is relative to Nunchia's defense request. To summon Mr. Yuk Chang, we share the opinion of the co-prosecutors, according to which the summoning of Mr. Yuk Chang's colleague, who has been working at DCCAM for more than 15 years, is timely, appropriate, and sufficient to providing this court information on how DCCAM has collected certain documents. However,
à toute discussion
in
qui
order
durer
to forestall any discussion that may go long go on for several more weeks or several more months as to whether or not Mr. Yuk Chang should be summoned, perhaps it would be appropriate to summon him. My second observation is this. It pertains to criteria of admissibility. Once again, I do not wish to add to what the co-prosecutor has already laid out before you. The trial chamber has already had the opportunity to examine criteria for admissibility. It will apply them, and I defer to the co-prosecutor in what he articulated with respect to those criteria. My third observation is this. With respect to how these criteria will be enforced,
la façon dont les objections vont être traitées,
and as to how the objections will be ruled upon, I would suggest that a very clear distinction be made between two categories of evidence. You have on the one hand evidence that has already been assessed by the co-investigating judges, and I insist on this. I'm talking about the written records of witness interviews, PVs, as well as other documents. And the second category of documents would be documents that have been brought forward by other parties and were not necessarily admitted by the co-investigating judges. I believe that the undertaking of this bench must take into account those two separate categories, categories of documents contained in the footnotes and those brought forward by other parties. Once again, I will recall that, subject to any appeal, the closing order does cure any procedural defects in the judicial investigation. I therefore implore Your Honours to take this into account while making your determination. My last remark is as follows. With respect to the indicia of reliability, as we have discussed, have already been taken into account by the co-investigating judges. I believe that to this date, and I'm referring strictly to the E3 category of documents. We shall deal with the other categories at a later point. I believe that some of the objections raised by the defense are indeed challenges that are far too broad, far too general. They are not serious objections that have any degree of accuracy or precision that can actually challenge the threshold by which the co-investigating judges conducted their work. I thank you, Your Honours.
President, thank you, lead co-lawyers.
Je vous remercie.
Each defense team now has a 15-minute right
Chacune
of
des
reply. Équipes
de défense a maintenant 15 minutes pour répliquer.
That is to both, to the prosecutions and to the lead co-lawyers' replies.
Et aux co-avocats principaux pour les parties civiles.
So it means for the three teams.
Donc,
you can divide the time amongst yourself.
Ou plutôt, les équipes de défense peuvent se partager le temps qui leur est alloué.
Le président, I'd like to state again the time allocation.
Que le temps alloué aux équipes de défense
the time allocation for the three defense teams
pour les trois équipes
you
de défense
15 minutes
est de 15
all
minutes
together
pour les trois équipes ensemble
replied.
So
it means for each
Cela
team, you only have 5 minutes.
Chacune des équipes dispose de 5 minutes pour sa réplique.
To reply to the responses of the co-prosecutors and the lead co-lawyers.
Par les procureurs et par les co-avocats principaux pour les parties civiles.
Except in the case where you reallocate the times amongst yourself.
Que vous partagiez.
The chamber now gives the floor to the Nunchi's defense.
Et la parole est maintenant à l'équipe de défense de Nunchi.
Thank you, Your Honors. Good morning, everyone. The Nunchi and team will take its 5 minutes. I don't think we can be much shorter than that. And I will limit my response to one point that the OCP made this morning, and I want to address this because
le président interrompt.
The president. I repeat, all the three teams have only 15 minutes in total, and your team has 5 minutes in response.
Vous avez 5 minutes pour répondre.
And if you need to use more than 5 minutes allocated for your team, you need to discuss among yourself.
Le faire avec l'accord de des autres équipes de défense.
Thank you, Your Honor. I hope my 5 minutes
Merci.
Start now.
Oui, j'espère que mes 5 minutes
and I will hurry up speaking.
Et j'essaierai de parler
Again,
plus vite.
We think that the OCP this morning misrepresented
Donc,
the defense's position.
A mal,
we have not stated
la position
that
de la défense ce matin.
All
Nous
DC
n'avons jamais déclaré
be,
que tous les documents de DC CAM devaient être déclarés irrecevables
CAM,
par
ce qui
provient de DC CAM, qui, selon nous, est un organisme partisan. Nous avons dit hier que si M. Yuk Chang n'est pas entendu, ce n'est qu'à ce moment-là que les documents devraient être jugés irrecevables.
And I will explain this.
Et laissez-moi expliquer pourquoi.
We think that
nous considérons
there are, numerous very valid questions with regards to the DCCAM documents that have not been addressed appropriately in the earlier interviews of Yuk Chang.
There
are very valid questions as to the provenance of numerous
documents.
There are valid questions as to the transfer to DCCAM of numerous documents. There are valid questions as to earlier custodians of these documents.
Quant à qui étaient les
dépositaires
avant DCCAM.
There are valid questions as to later additions
sur
to
des additions DK plus
era
tard
documents by other people, other people than Khmer
Rouge
officials. As I mentioned yesterday,
comme je l'ai dit hier,
it seems that, for example, Tool Slang
Museum
staff has added to these documents, and
DCCAM
personnel may have added to these documents. Those are all valid questions. One last point with regard to those questions,
Yuk
Chang has also stated
that
to get certain documents, he needed to work with the permission of the government, with the permission of Hun Sen personally,
avec la permission
and this means
personnelle
that Hun Sen,
ce qui signifie que M. Hun Sen lui-même a le contrôle
de certains documents.
And,
we need to be able
et nous
to question
devons être en mesure
Yuk Chang
de poser des questions à Yuk Chang
as well.
Sur ces sujets.
Again, it is imperative that we hear Yuk
il est aussi impératif que nous entendions
Yuk
Chang
so
sur ces points, car il a participé personnellement à la collecte de ces documents.
I already explained yesterday that he personally accepted each and every document, and I would like to quote one statement that he made in document number D311/2.
His
question is asked by the investigating judges, could you give your personal notes about the receipt and types of documents, and the answer of Yuk Chang is, I have my personal notes, but other people do not understand its meaning, and it only means to me. Translation by me, we need to hear Yuk Chang on these issues.
Nous devons entendre Yuk Chang.
The other witness that has been called may be able to testify about some issues of custody, but it is clear that Yuk Chang is the right party to ask about the much broader issues. He knows more about custody, but also he knows more about the authenticity and the reliability
sur
of
certains points,
documents.
Notamment l'authenticité et la fiabilité de ces documents.
I want to
C'était
make.
Le dernier point
we are
que
not
je voulais
just focusing on
Donc,
the custody of these documents.
Pas simplement
we are also
la conservation
on the
des documents,
authenticity
mais aussi l'authenticité
of these documents.
Des documents.
I feel that so far the position
Jusqu'à
seems
présent,
to be of the OCP that these
la
documents
de are est que ces documents
because
DCCAM sont authentiques
has
car
stated that
DCCAM
they are
a
authentic.
Déclaré qu'ils l'étaient.
And this can be translated to
Et
these documents are considered to be authentic because
que ces documents sont considérés
says
être authentiques car Yuk Chang dit qu'ils
reason,
sont authentiques et c'est pourquoi nous devons
on his training,
interroger
on his
Yuk Chang
approach,
sur sa formation,
technical
son
knowledge,
approche, sa méthodologie et ses
also,
connaissances techniques,
again, I repeat,
et aussi,
his
je le répète,
stated preference for
sa préférence
a handwriting sample
avouée
and perhaps forensic testing of documents. Mais il a dit lui-même que ses documents authentiques pourraient être nécessaires pour
véritablement authentifier le document. Autrement dit, lui-même n'est pas convaincu approach. De sa propre approche.
So, to summarize our position,
pour résumer la position de l'équipe de défense de Nunchia, si nous ne pouvons obtenir les précisions
by DCCAM on the
quant à l'approche de DCCAM pour l'authentification des documents,
we do not hear
si
Yu Cheng,
nous ne pouvons entendre
Yu Cheng,
ces documents ne peuvent être considérés comme authentiques
There will
et fiables.
Black box
et ce
called
sera
DCCAM, of which we do not know,
ces documents provenant de DCCAM. Et DCCAM sera comme un trou noir dont on ne connaît pas l'approche, l'expertise, la méthodologie. Et c'est pourquoi nous demandons que Yu Cheng soit cité à comparaître. Et voilà la position de la défense sur la admissibilité de ces documents. J'espère que je n'ai pas dépassé mes 5 minutes et je laisse maintenant la parole à mes collègues.
President, thank you, Defense
le Président,
Council.
Oui, merci.
Yinsri Defense,
l'équipe de défense de Yinsri, vous avez la parole.
Good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honors, and good morning to everyone in and around the courtroom. I apologize if I may be speaking a little bit faster than normally.
Je parle plus rapidement que d'habitude,
but I have a lot of territory to cover.
Beaucoup de choses à dire.
First, let me work backwards. The civil parties talk about the threshold that was used by the OCIJ in determining that the documents were authentic, reliable, and of course relevant. What threshold?
Quel seul,
I remind you that we filed a third investigative constant battle that is going on now
Gardons à l'esprit
with respect
la lutte.
To that particular organ of this particular institution,
Intestine
I don't think that we can just
tribunal.
Simply say that it has that much credibility
and we should therefore accept it blindly. Et que nous devons accepter,
Let me talk about very briefly the examples that were raised by the national co-prosecutor,
que le procureur
who, in my opinion,
a soulevé.
Simply made an offer of proof, or put it more bluntly, testified as
Et
to why
en fait,
he believes these documents
moi,
are authentic and reliable.
Témoigné lui-même sur son
he
opinion
claims
et pourquoi il pense que ces documents sont fiables et authentiques. Il affirme que le contenu est cohérent et il donne ensuite des exemples de mots que l'on retrouve dans
That's
les documents. Ça, c'est le témoignage de M.
Chandler-Rasmus.
C'est une proposition de preuve faite par l'accusation.
Somehow,
Mais ils en sont arrivés, d'une façon ou d'une autre, à la conclusion que ces mots
certain individuals or certain organizations.
If that is the case, avec un certain organisme ou une certaine personne, si c'est le cas, pourquoi ne pas faire apparaître ces personnes ou montrer d'une façon ou d'une autre pourquoi cela concorde et que cela est cohérent en soi. Le simple fait
where they make an offer of proof is insufficient.
De présenter cet argument n'est pas suffisant.
And then it seems to be that because they made this offer of proof in writing in their submission, they want to reverse the burden on the defense, and somehow we have to now carry that burden. We submit, Your Honors, that in the international jurisprudence, it works the other way around. And that brings me to what the international co-prosecutor indicated. And yesterday we heard about the Perlis case.
Now, De l'affaire
it was déjà vu for me because
moi,
I spent 5 years litigating
Perlis,
representing Dr.
Perlis.
And the procedure that was used in that case,
et la procédure que l'on a utilisée
granted,
dans cette affaire, je suis d'accord, il s'agissait d'une
hybrid
procédure
system.
Contradictoire
but
dans
in
ce
that particular
hybride,
system,
mais dans
and now
ce système,
I'm making an offer of proof, but
et là,
I will provide the trial chamber with all of the decisions concerning the admissibility of evidence.
À la Chambre toutes les décisions the sur prosecution la question de la recevabilité l'accusation devait présenter
not necessarily with a chain of custody, but a custodian
as to how the documents were generated. Et qui allait expliquer sur la façon dont les documents étaient générés. Nous avons ensuite entendu des témoignages de différents témoins, et à l'issue de ces témoignages, l'accusation
présentait
certains documents.
The trial chamber would then make a decision.
S'opposer la défense et la chambre rendait sa décision.
Limitations were not presented to witnesses.
Si les documents n'étaient pas présentés
then,
aux
through
témoins,
the bar table, we were able, as a last resort, to make an offering.
Nous pouvions directement
the parties would have the right to object, and the court
déposer
would
les documents, présenter les documents, et ensuite
it's
les parties pouvaient présenter leurs objections.
Totally
c'est un processus qui est totalement distinct.
Here,
je ne suggère pas que l'on l'adopte ici, mais si l'on est pour invoquer des normes internationales, la norme n'est pas, comme le prétend l'accusation, qu'il s'agit simplement d'étudier la pertinence. Si un document
then
semble être pertinent de prima facie,
because authenticity and right liability are
il faut l'accepter, car l'authenticité et la fiabilité sont une seule chose que l'on peut déterminer plus tard, et cela
we
ira toucher la valeur probante. Ça, c'est la suggestion
and
d'accusation, et nous disons que ce n'est pas le cas. Et bien que j'apprécie le compliment qu'on m'a fait, que hier, j'ai fait preuve de propos universitaires, enfin académiques en anglais, je ne dis pas que c'était le cas,
ruminate over, you know, whether it's authentic, and then after a while go to whether it's reliable.
Je ne vous demande pas de parler de la pertinence et d'y penser pendant très longtemps et qu'il faille. C'est très rapide de déterminer la pertinence, l'authenticité, la fiabilité.
There has to be some sort of
il faut qu'il existe une méthodologie
for your honors to look at all of the evidence and to
simply say that it comes from
this institution. Or that it has
et le simple fait
this
de dire
logo,
ça provient de tel organisme,
and therefore from this logo,
ça,
take it from us, the prosecution,
tel logo,
it means that it's a reliable, authentic,
nous disons qu'il s'agit là de quelque chose qui prouve qu'il est pertinent, fiable et authentique,
and finally,
ce n'est pas
with
suffisant.
Respect to articles and newspapers,
finalement, en ce qui a trait aux articles de la presse.
Actually, that's my second to last point. In some courts, bon,
mon avant-dernier point,
in some, before some chambers, and I believe
dans
it was the Peskovsky chamber.
Et je crois que c'était dans la chambre dans l'affaire Peskovsky. Je
Judge
devrais
Parker,
vérifier.
Who presided
le juge Parker,
over the,
qui présidait
over that particular case,
ce,
did not rely on any
ce procès
newspapers.
N'a pas dépendu d'articles de journaux.
Newspaper articles. The trial chamber in that case determined that that was insufficient.
Now, a jugé
I can understand that in this particular tribunal, we may wish
je sais
to
que
look
dans
at,
le tribunal,
but I don't think that simply
enfin,
because
ce tribunal,
it says Reuters,
contribu-
it comes in, or Washington Post, it comes in, and everything in it
journaux, mais ce n'est pas parce que
can
cela
be
de Reuters ou de Washington Post qu'il faut absolument que cela
therein.
Soit jugé recevable.
Finally, and this is my final point, Your Honors,
dernier point.
With respect to Doik and the Doik case.
Quant à Doik et l'affaire, le dossier
I wasn't at the, in the Doik case.
Je n'étais pas présent pour
he
l'affaire
was represented
Doik.
By another team
il était représenté par une autre équipe de défense qui avait une autre
that
stratégie.
In essence came in and pled, he pled guilty.
Et puis, bon, il a,
and there was an 8-month
plaidé coupable,
trial process to determine whether he was indeed guilty, which is the civil law system.
Pour ensuite
but to simply say that because we did this in Doik,
le simple fait de dire que l'on l'a fait
we should automatically do it in this case.
Et que l'on, cela signifie que l'on doit le faire dans ce cas-ci, n'a pas de sens.
That is not
je suggère respectueusement que ce n'est pas
case,
le nouveau critère. Il s'agit d'un nouveau procès et nous devons avoir une approche vis-à-vis des pièces
for, and
qui est
différente.
Je suis
ici
pour représenter les intérêts de Yang Sari. J'ai le droit de soulever mes objections. J'ai le droit de demander à l'accusation qu'elle satisfasse à son fardeau minimal. Pour les éléments de preuve, je n'étais pas là pour le dossier 1. Et je n'ai pas, enfin, mon client n'a pas à être pénalisé parce que les avocats dans le dossier 1 ont choisi qu'il n'était pas dans leur intérêt ou dans leur théorie de l'affaire de contester certains types de documents. Je regrette d'avoir parlé si vite. 5 minutes, c'est bien peu. Et n'est pas assez pour faire ma présentation, mais j'apprécie l'occasion qui m'est donnée de répliquer. Je vous remercie.
Thank you.
Le président.
Finally, we hand over the floor to the defense for Kyusun Pon. You may now proceed.
Je vous en prie.
Mr. Kung Sumon, thank you, Mr. President, your honors.
Merci, Monsieur le Président, Madame, Messieurs les Juges.
I would like to object to the response by the prosecution
that
the time for the 4-year time for examination of documents in the case file is more than sufficient, but in reality it is not the case. The reason why I raised my argument earlier on, because I was based on a solid ground. We are human beings, we are not God, we are not machine, so the examinations of documents, in certain cases we can do it with yes, but in other instances it may not. And the prosecution was erroneous when they pointed out that those documents, thousands of documents in the case file was available at one specific time some 4 years ago, but it was not the case because many documents has been added to the case files and it has gone through translation and so it does not and we have some problems finding certain document in the language that we are conversant with. That is also an issue confronting the defense.
Voilà un autre problème auquel a été confrontée la défense. Deuxième point.
The prosecution just now mentioned by themselves that this is a large case.
De dire elle-même qu'il s'agissait d'un dossier d'une grande ampleur.
So this case involves voluminous documents, and the standard of proof must meet certain defined criteria.
Certains critères de preuve doivent être remplis.
Legally speaking, when we talk about the standard of admissibility of the document, regardless of the size of the case, but we will have to have a minimum standard of admissibility. And in this case, before us is a large case, and there should be a standard of admissibility. And the prosecution, in their response, said they make an analogy that the gathering of evidence, for example, the police gathered evidence. They say that the police might be biased and the document gathered by the police may not be admissible by the chamber. Well, actually, the police are the public officers and they protect the interests of the public. However,
de faire régner l'ordre public,
the DC CAM is a privately run organization. It may serve the interests of the public by keeping the custody of the document, but it is not actually an official function of this organization.
Dépositeur de certains documents, mais la défense des intérêts du public ne constitue pas le mandat principal.
And I observe that the prosecution does not argue that the chamber should summon Mr. Chang-yok to testify before the court. Even in the domestic jurisdiction, the police are at times summoned to testify before the court as well. So Mr.
Chang-yok
has to appear before this chamber upon summoned by the court.
Devrait donc être cité à comparaître par les chambres, par la chambre.
As for the use of time, the prosecution and the representative of the civil parties argued that if we have to summon each and every witness, then it will lead to the prolonged proceedings.
Cela allongerait le procès.
But defense takes the position that in search for truth and justice, if it is necessary to ascertain the truth, we will have to summon those important witnesses. If we do not have the indicia of reliability or relevance of the document, it is more than necessary to summon those witnesses. Otherwise, the chambers would make a decision based on the document that were not substantiated. For example, the argument raised by a national prosecutor just now, he said Mr. Kyusampon used to be the President of State President. So, of course, if we look at the time for the prosecution to work, they actually had worked on the document for 4 years already.
Sur les documents depuis déjà 4 ans.
He was not the head of the state, but he was the president of the state presidium. So I think that the prosecution may be erroneous, let alone the journalists. They are sometimes foreign journalists or foreign authors. They did not understand the historical context and the actual context of Cambodia overall. So they were subject to erroneous statement or statement as well. And in that document, it also pointed that Mr. Kyusampon used to be the prime minister as well.
But
Mr. Kyusampon had never been an acting prime minister at all. But there were some news articles which printed the report that Mr. Kyusampon had been the acting prime minister. So once again, if we fail to look in depth into the document, then we would not be able to assess its reliability. There are a number of other points which I already presented yesterday, and I think the prosecution failed to respond to the points I made yesterday as to whether or not there was existence of those kinds of things. Once again, the earnest request of the defense to examine the reliability and relevance of the document is indispensable to ascertain the correctness and properness of the document, which serve as the solid basis for the decision of the chamber. So long as we have a specific clarification of the source of document, the reliability of the document, as well as the reliability of the content of the document, the chamber may make a prejudicial decision on the admissibility of those documents. Thank you.
Se prononcer convenablement au sujet de la recevabilité.
Thank you, counsel. It is now appropriate to take an adjournment, and we will take a 20-minute break. We will resume at 11.
Nous reprendrons donc à 11 heures.